Welcome back to CADCAM tutorial. Today we are going to learn some basic commands of SOLIDWORKS sheet metal. So let's start. Go to file, new, and choose here part. Now let me choose some. Now here you will see sheet metal. If you like, you can directly right click on this command manager and choose sheet metal from here. So now let's see, there are a few basic tools from this sheet metal, and we will create a simple drawing. So let me choose with top plane, sketch, center rectangle. Okay, now let me draw. See, if you want to make curve, just go back this end point. See, now it will automatically, it will convert into arc. Press, then again it will you will continue, it will convert in line. Exit. That's it. Now let's mirror this one. Mirror. Now choose these three lines. Mirror about. Keep here, copy. This is the construction. This construction line is the mirror. Okay. We need to create one hole here. It's time to define 100 millimeter. Millimeter. Keep this radius 10, outer radius 10, and inner diameter 10. Now let me choose this one, inner diameter 10, and this one by default 10 millimeter. This is also 30 millimeter by default. Now here we need to create some relations. Now choose this line and horizontal and vertical line, make relation equal. That's it. Now choose this circle center point and origin point. That's it. Now this drawing is fully defined, but better to trim this face. Choose trim entity, go to power trim, just press your left key and drag. See, it is trimmed. The same thing we will do it here. Okay. Now it might show some drawing is not fully defined, so we have one option. Just click here, drop down this menu, choose fully defined sketch, calculate, cancel. It is not going to show, so better add some dimension. Okay, now see, drawing is fully defined. Exit. Go to sheet metal and choose here base flange tab. Now we want to expand. Let's say thickness 1.5 millimeter. Look, this looks fine. K factor, actually it is a it is helpful for calculation of bending allowance. So we, in general, we are going to keep K factor 0.5. Now here you can make the thickness reverse. See, it's going upward direction, but let's say downward direction. Okay, okay, that's it. Now let me choose here perspective view. Now it's time to see, there is one option, edge flange. I'll choose this edge and drag your mouse upward direction. Okay, now the same thing, just click here. These two edges we are going to expand. Now I'll see this way. See, I selected this edge here. Use default radius. Radius we can define according to our requirement, 3 millimeter. See, its radius become big if we choose 2 millimeter. So let's say 3 millimeter. 90 degree, the bending we need 90 degree. Whatever angle you need, you can put it here. Now the length, blind length, the vertical length, how much length do you want? So let's say 40 millimeter. Now here outer virtual, this sharpness calculation going to take, let's say outer virtual shaft. See, it is going to calculate from the center. You can see this drawing and you will understand. Now see, let's say we calculated from here, and the flange position, material thickness position. Now let's here material inside, let me keep material outside. You can see material little move outside, half radius move outside. Now see the full radius move outside. So it's up to you, what do you like. So I like to keep from the inside material. Okay, everything same, that's it. Now let me again choose and select this outer one and drag this side. Now let me choose this outer one, it's going this side, everything same. Now here everything same, we just selected here two edges. Now the radius default we can set, so previously we set 3 millimeter, so here also we will make same 3 millimeter angle, and the length we will reduce, let's say 25 millimeter, and let's say here this time we will choose virtual shaft inner. Material we took inside, you can take outside also, it's up to you. Trim bend side, okay. Now custom allowance bending, see K factor bending calculation, K factor 0.5, okay. Now see, now let's add one bend here. So how we will do this one? First we will create path for bend. So choose this face sketch line and let me draw one line, exit. Now let's define this 5 mm. Now here I want to make bend. So how we will do this one? Sheet metal, and here we have one option, sketch bend, add bend from selected sketch in it. So choose sketch bend. Now here first you have to choose fixed face, so we will choose this fixed face. Now see, once we selected, it's going upward direction. Now here you have to choose the position, material inside, outside, or too much outside, means it's outside from the bend, 90 degree. Use default radius, let's say 3 millimeter. See, now suppose you want to make bend downward side, so let me choose reverse side. See, it's going reverse direction. Okay, that's it. Okay, so this is how simply we created a simple part with the help of sheet metal. We learned some few basic tools of sheet metal. Sorry guys, let me add some holes so that it looks perfect. Sketch, now let's add some hole here. You will find here on center line, better to make again same center line, or you can directly select also, choose both the lines for construction purpose and select circle, and I'll keep this diameter 6 millimeter, 6 millimeter, 6 millimeter, 6 millimeter. Even you can choose one option select all the circles and make relation equal. Delete. 6 millimeter. Okay, now make relation these two holes parallel and these two holes parallel. Let's define some relation. Okay, this is by default. Now distance from outer edge 20. The same, let's define from this side 20. Now see, the all holes are fully defined. If you'll see sheet metal, and here you'll find extruded cut. You can directly choose thickness to cut, or you can simply select link to thickness, so that it will cut only thickness up to the sheet thickness. It will cut up to the thickness. Okay. So this is how we created a simple 3D sheet metal model in SolidWorks with the help of some basic tools of sheet metal. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.